Hi children, welcome back to the online classes. This is the second session of the chapter sound. So in this session we will see about how the humans are able to produce sound. How humans, sounds produced by humans. So is it necessary for humans to produce sound?
Yes, it is very important
to communicate each other. For humans, we are communicating each other. To communicate with each other, we need humans. So on ancient time, the humans are not able to speak. So on that time, they will use some symbols for communication. So because of the sound, we are able to communicate. We can able to exchange the information clearly. We can express our feelings clearly. Okay, so that's why the sounds was essential for humans. How the humans are creating sounds? How humans are creating sound? So if you observe the neck of the humans, if you observe the neck, there will be a bump at the neck part. There will be some bump at the neck part. We will call this as voice box. We will call this as voice box. Voice box or larynx. Voice box or larynx. So this is the reason for producing sound. So how the sound will be produced? Sound is produced by the objects with vibrations. Vibrations of the objects will create sound. Vibrations in the object produce sound. So those vibrations will travel along the medium. The sound vibrations will be like this. They will travel in the air like this. Okay, the vibrations of the sound will be like this. So in such a way, here if you observe, place your hand on your neck, place your hand on your neck and speak. So what you can what will you observe is, while you are speaking, you can observe the vibrations creating here. You can observe the vibrations creating here. If you touch here, you cannot, while speaking, you cannot observe the vibrations here. Why? Because the main voice creating voice, the sound producing part is here. It is located at the neck. We will call that as voice box, or the biological name is larynx. So this is voice box. So it is just a neck part. It consists of a pipe like structure. So in that pipe like structure, so this is, let us say this as voice box, this as voice box. This is voice box. This is nothing but a pipe like structure. So I was drawn like this. So here this voice box, this larynx, voice box consists of a muscular ligament arrangement. Muscular ligaments. So this voice box consists of voice box. Consists of muscular ligaments arrangement. Muscular ligaments arrangement. This voice box consists of muscular ligament arrangements. There are different types of muscles are there. There are different types of muscles are there. So here ligaments means it is a strong and some strings like muscles will be there. So that muscle ligament arrangement are called as vocal cords. This is nothing but vocal cords. You can observe the diagram of this voice box in your textbooks. If you have textbook, watch it. So there is a muscular arrangement. This voice box, this larynx consists of muscular ligaments arrangement, an arrangement with muscular ligaments called as vocal cords. And a narrow slit will be there. These muscles will be able to open some space, will create this, these muscles, this muscular arrangement will able to create a narrow space. and sometimes it will close narrow space. The arrangement will be like that. So inside the voice box, some muscles will be arranged. How those will be arranged is they are able to open. They are able to open and sometimes creates narrow space, and they are able to close. So let us see. Whenever we are breathing, what will happen? The muscles, these vocal cords, will open up and creates a narrow space. So this is the throat of the human eyes. So this is the throat. So here muscular arrangement will be there, and this is your lungs. So we will call this as windpipe. Windpipe. So whenever you are taking air, this muscular arrangement of vocal cords is nothing but a muscular arrangement present inside the voice box. Whenever you are taking air, these two muscles will open up and creates a narrow space to allow the air to pass through it. It allows, opens up. Why? Because to allow the air into the lungs. So whenever you are creating sound, this will be closed. The vocal cords will be closed, and the air present inside the windpipe will apply some force on the vocal cords and creates vibrations in the vocal cord. So while you are talking, while you are speaking, while you are singing, you cannot able to breathe. Why? Because while speaking or singing, your vocal cords will be kept closed. So it will be kept closed, and the air will apply some force. The air present in the windpipe will apply some force on the vocal cords in order to vibrate this muscular arrangement, in order to vibrate the vocal cords. So while you are speaking, while you are singing, this vocal cords will be kept closed. So that's why you are able to speak. The vibrations in the vocal cords creates sound. So here the size of vocal cords of men is about 20 millimeters. It is in circular shape. The diameter of the vocal cords arrangement for men is about 20 millimeters, and the size for the woman is, it is 5 mm less than men, and children it is very less. For children, the size of the vocal cord is different. So because of the size difference of the vocal cords, we will have some difference between voices of men and women. Men and women voice are not same. Why? Because there are several reasons, and one of the reason is the size of the vocal cords. And this is the reason. So the main vibrations will be produced at the vocal cords. So in this way, the humans were able to produce sound. So whatever the sound you are making, that sound was obtained by the vibrations of the vocal cord. The vibrations in the vocal cord has created the sound. So let us recap this topic again. So at the position of neck, the voice box will be presented. The voice box, we will call it as larynx, will be presented at the neck. And this larynx consists of muscular ligament arrangement. We will call muscular ligament arrangement called as vocal cords. That muscular arrangement will create narrow space when you are taking air. When you are breathing, it will opens up and creates a narrow space. And whenever you are speaking or singing, the vocal cords will be closed. Whenever you are speaking, the vocal cords will be closed. The air presented inside the windpipe applies force on the vocal cords and makes the vocal cord to vibrate. In such a way, the vibrations in the vocal cord will generate sound. The vibrations in the vocal cord will generate sound. And the size of the vocal cords for men is about 20 mm and size of vocal cords of women is 15 mm. So that's why you will observe some difference, different voices for men and women. So this is about sound produced by humans, sounds produced by humans. Now, okay, the humans are able to create sounds by using voice box. Then how they are able to hear that sound? How they are able to hear that sound? So you are listening to this class, you are getting some sound to your mobile phone. How you are able to listen? By using your ears. Your ears are the sense organs that receives the sound. Let us learn about how humans are able to listen sound. How humans are able to listen sound. So that means we will learn about the function of the ear. We will learn about the function of the ear. What is the function of the ear? So function of ear. Function of ear. So why we are learning about ear? Till now we have discussed how we are producing sound, and now we are discussing how we are able to receive that sound. What is the arrangement that present inside the ear that allows you to listen the sound? So ear has consists of mainly three portions. One is outer ear, middle ear, and inner ear. So let us see how the ear is able to listen the sound. So the outer section part of the ear, here this you can see the outer part of the ear. So this is the outer part of the ear. We will call this as pinna or pinna is the outer part of the ear. You can see with your eyes. This we will call it as pinna. So this outer part of the ear is used for collecting the sound. It acts as a funnel. So if you went inside the ear, this is auditory canal. We will call this as auditory canal. So the biological name was different. We are analyzing the physical property of the ear. Physics only we are learning. That's why the biological name may be different, but according to from our physics subject, so we will call this as auditory canal. The sound will passes through this canal and we will call this as eardrum. So up to from pinna to eardrum, we will call this section as outer ear. From up to pinna to eardrum. Eardrum means the biological name is tympanum. So tympanum membrane. So this is nothing but eardrum. So up to pinna to eardrum, we will call this section as outer ear. From eardrum onwards, we will call this as middle ear. And this middle ear consists of three bones. One is malleus, incus, stapes. So malleus is in the shape of hammer. There are three bones are there. small bones, very very small bones will be there. Small bones will be presented here. Small bones will be presented here. So the internal structure will be different. So it is very very small in size. Here you can observe the three bones will be presented here only. So here three bones, this is called as middle ear, from eardrum to this last bone. I will explain it. So this middle part of ear, so middle ear consists of three bones, three small bones will be there. So what are the name of the three small bones? Malleus, incus, stapes. These are extremely small, very very small. So malleus is in the shape of hammer and this incus is in the shape of anvil. So this is, as usually you can observe at the iron shop. So some swords will make by using this anvil. So they will place the iron rod here and use it to hammer the iron rods on this anvil. We will call this as anvil. So incus is in the shape of anvil and stapes are in the shape of stirrup. Means the polices will have some bedis. So what is the shape of the bedis? So this will be like this, right? So this shape is called as stirrup. So here in the middle section of the ear consists of three small bones, that is malleus, incus, stapes and stirrup. So this arrangement is to increase the vibrations. So some sound is reaching into the ear, those vibrations will strike the eardrum and makes the eardrum to vibrate. Those vibrations will reach the ear and makes the eardrum to vibrate. So those vibrations will be transferred to the bones, malleus, incus, stapes. So vibrations of the eardrum, when you catch the sound, when the outer section of the ear collects the sound, those vibrations will travel through the auditory canal and reaches the eardrum, and the sound makes the eardrum to vibrate. The vibrations from the eardrum transfers to the middle ear. So the middle ear consists of three bones. So these three bones will increase the vibrations. And the last bone, stapes is connected to, from eardrum to stapes that portion is called as middle ear, and after stapes that portion will be called as inner ear. The stapes is connected to oval window of membrane. So in the inner ear consists of cochlea, some snail like structure will, you can observe here. So it that part is called as cochlea. So here the stapes is connected at oval window of membrane. There will be some place where the stapes is connected. Oval window means gap on the walls. So that window, the cochlea will consist of a small gap where the stapes was attached. So the stapes is connected to oval window of membrane. Do you know the size of this oval window of membrane? Its size is 1/20 of size of eardrum. It is very very small when compared with the size of the eardrum. So eardrum, the oval window of membrane size is 1/20 times lesser, 20 times smaller than the size of eardrum. So the stapes is attached to the oval window of membrane. which is 1/20th size of eardrum. Here size of the membrane decreases. Because of the decrease in size, because of the decrease in size of the membrane, the vibrations will be increased up to 30 to 60 times. Here the vibrations will be increased 30 to 60 times due to the size of the oval window of membrane. Due to the size of the oval window of membrane, the vibrations will be increased up to 30 to 60 times. So in this way, the particular arrangement, the middle ear section and the inner section, which consists of oval window of membrane, this all arrangements will increase the vibrations, will increase the vibrations inside the ear. So the vibrations will passes through the middle bones consists in the middle ear. It reaches to the liquid present in the cochlea. So here initially the vibrations are captured by eardrum. The sound vibrations will be captured by eardrum, and these vibrations are transferred to three bones present in the middle ear, and again these vibrations are transferred into the inner part of the ear. So it is there, those vibrations will be transferred to cochlea, and that cochlea will consist of a fluid. So in this cochlea some fluid will be presented. So the fluid will starts moving, and under the fluid there is some hair like structure will present. So in the cochlea, the liquid will present inside this cochlea, and under the liquid some hair like structure will be there. So the vibrations from the oval window will be presented here. The vibrations from the oral window will be captured by this liquid, and this liquid makes this hair like structure to vibrate. So this vibrations will create, the vibrations in this hair like structure create signals and transfers it to our brain. So here the signals are captured by the hair like structure presented inside the cochlea. So those signals will be read by our brain. So this is the function of the ear. In this way we are able to listen the sound. So let us recap that again. So the ear consists of the total ear. The structure of the ear is divided into three parts. One is outer ear, middle ear and inner ear. So outer ear, you can see the outer ear, we will call that part as pinnae. So from pinnae to eardrum, that section is called as outer ear. What is the function of this pinnae? The function is to collect the sound, from the outside. It will collect the sound and passes, sound is nothing but vibrations, and it allows the vibrations to pass through the auditory canal. Those vibrations will reach us to the eardrum and makes the eardrum to vibrate. You can observe the eardrum here, and makes the eardrum to vibrate. So that eardrum is attached to the three small bones presented inside the ear. What are the small bones presented inside the ear? Malleus, incus and stapes. Malleus is in the shape of hammer, incus is in the shape of anvil, and stapes are in the shape of stirrup. So these are extremely very small bones. This arrangement, the small sizes of our arrangement will able to increase the received sound, and stapes is connected to oval window of membrane. And the size of oval window of membrane is 1/20th of the size of eardrum. It is very very small. So because of its size, this oval window of membrane can able to increase the vibrations from 30 to 60 times. If the size decreases, the vibrations will increase. So here the oval window is having 1/20 times smaller than the size of the eardrum. So later the vibrations from the oval window of membrane reaches to the liquid present in the cochlea, and under that liquid some hair like structures will be there. So the vibrations of the liquid will catch by this hair like structures, and those hair like structures will create some signals to the brain. So those signals will be read by our brain. So this is the function of the ear. So in this session what we have learned, we have seen how the humans will produce sound and how the humans are able to listen the sound. So in the next session we will learn about what are the main characteristics of sound, what is the nature of the sound. We will hear different sounds. Some sounds may be loud, some sounds may be irritating. If you observe the sound of the mosquito, it is very irritating. The sounds of the mosquito, honeybees, if the mosquito makes a sound near to your ear, is it very pleasant to hear? No, it is very irritating sounds. And if you listen the music, it is very pleasant, noise, very unpleasant. In such a way, there are different sounds are there. Why the differences was occurred from one sound to sound, what is the difference? So to know about that, we need to know the natures of the sound. We need to know the properties of the sound. So in this session, we will learn about characteristics. Characteristics. What are the properties that distinguishes the sound? Characteristics of sound. We will learn in the next session. So with this session was completed. Thank you.